Good evening, friends. Welcome to our aptitude training session, and this is our 10th session. Today we are going to discuss a topic called clocks and calendars. So you may get at least 2 questions in these topics in your campus interview. So we are going to discuss these 2 topics today. So this is the plan for the day. So we are going to discuss clocks and calendars, and then I'll tell you about the national level coding contest which we are going to conduct on April 15th. It's called Codespiration. Watch the video till the end. I'll tell the procedure to register as well as the exclusive prizes which you are going to give for the winners. So many of you know about our Facebook live training session. So you can watch this live video in Facebook page as well as placementseason.com web page itself. So if you want, if you have any access issue with Facebook, you can watch this video in placementseason.com and click live to watch this video. So in case if you miss this video, you can watch our recorded video in prep.placementseason.com and app.placementseason YouTube channel as well as Facebook video page. So let's start the session. So in quantitative aptitude, we'll get the problems based on analog clock. That is the clock like this. We don't get the problems related to digital clock. Digital clock means the time display something like this, 11:35 or 9:20. We don't get the problems related to digital clock in aptitude. We'll get the problems related to analog clock only. Also, our problems are mostly related to this hour hand and minute hand. Small one is hour hand and the bigger one is minute hand. So now imagine, so the time in this clock is 1:50. Now imagine the clock at 12 o'clock. So 12 o'clock, your hour hand will look like this and minute hand will also look like this. It means the angle between hour hand and minute hand is 0 degree. So imagine the clock at 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock and 3 o'clock. At 12 o'clock, your hour hand and minute hand will look like this. At 6 o'clock, it will point in opposite direction. If this is hour hand and this will be your minute hand. And 3 o'clock, it will look like 90. It's looked like L. So the angle between hour hand and minute hand at 12 o'clock is 0 degree. At 6 o'clock, 180 degree. And 3 o'clock, 90 degree. So most of our problems are related to this concept. So if you understand this clearly, you can solve all the problems related to clock concept. Okay. So I said the angle between hour hand and minute hand at 12 o'clock is 0 degree. So what are the other times we will get the same scenario? That is, when, how many times the hour hand and minute hand coincides in 12 hours. So to understand this, let's look another image. So see this image now. Here at 12 o'clock, this is hour hand and this is minute hand. So 12 o'clock, both hour hand and minute hand coincides, and the angle between hour hand and minute hand is 0 degree. So next to 12 o'clock, it coincides at 1:05 at this place. So after, it coincides at this place. And third one is here and fourth. So if you count this, you will get 11. So it means the clock coincides 11 times in 12 hours. So why there is a difference between these two? So it coincides only 11 times, but actual hour is 12 hours. So if you look at this image, you can understand clearly. So the clock coincides at least once in this time gap. So between 1 and 2, it coincides here. Between 2 and 3, it coincides here. So it means it coincides at least once between this time gap. But if you look at the time gap between 11 to 1, it coincides exactly at 12 o'clock. There is no coincidence between 11 to 12 or 12 to 1. It coincides exactly at 12 o'clock. So the count 1 is coming in a difference. So simply remember, in 12 hours, the hands of the clock coincides 11 times. Similarly, imagine the clock at 6 o'clock. So 6 o'clock, the hands of the clock will be in opposite and it will be looks like a straight line. So we have discussed an example in the previous slide and found that the hands of the clock coincides 11 times. Similarly, the hands of the clock will be in straight line and opposite 11 times. Also, the right angle you will get 22 right angle in 12 hours. So the right angle means, let me explain with a simple example. Consider the clock. Assume that time is 4 o'clock. I am not drawing the minute hand. I just draw the it around the hour hand. So there are two scenarios you will get right angle. So minute hand at this place and the minute hand after this. So there are chances for two right angles between 4 to 5. That is, first right angle will be around 4 o'clock and 5 minutes, and second right angle will be at 4 o'clock 37 or 38 minutes. So if you remember these three values, that is more than enough to solve clocks related problems. So in case if you want to understand this right angle, straight line and coincide concept in a better way, take a clock and rotate the minute hand and check this. But these three values is enough to solve the problems related to clocks concept. Let's discuss a simple example based on this. How many times in a day are the hands of clock in straight line but opposite in direction? So we have discussed there are 11 straight lines and opposite in 12 hours. But what is our question? They have asked how many times in a day. So double the value. So 22 times. So based on this question, you have to answer. So sometimes they will ask how many times it will coincide in a day, how many times it will coincide in a week or in a month. So based on this, you have to answer. But just remember the basic three concepts which we have discussed in the earlier slide. It is enough to solve the problems. Let's discuss the different types of problems which we can expect in clocks concept. The first problem is, you have to find the angle between hour hand and minute hand. The second type is, you have to calculate the exact time when the minute hand and hour hand coincides or right angle or straight line based on the scenario. So you have to calculate the exact time. And third concept is based on fast or slow clock. The clocks might run faster or slower than the usual clock. So we'll be discussing these three concepts in the next upcoming slides. So if you want to find the angle between hour hand or minute hand, you can simply use the formula. Don't confuse with any other degree or movement of the hour hand or minute hand. Simply substitute the value in this formula and get the answer. M indicates minutes and H indicates hour. This is the difference between these two values. M by 2, 11 M by 2, difference 3, that's 30 H. What is the angle between the hands of clock at 4:10? So we have discussed the formula. 11 M by 2, difference 30 H. So what is the value of M? It is 10 here. So 11 into 10 by 2 minus 30 into H is 4. So simplify this, you will get 110 by 2 minus 120. So if you simplify, you will get 65 degrees. So the angle between the hour hand and minute hand is 65 degrees at 4:10. So sometimes you may get a question like, what is the angle, what is the reflex angle between the hands of the clock at particular time? So reflex angle means it is opposite to the angle which we form. For example, this is the clock. So I am drawing the clock at 1 o'clock. So the angle between hour hand and minute hand at 1 o'clock is 30 degrees. So the reflex angle means you have to take the opposite angle. So opposite angle, total angle is 360 degrees minus 30. So the opposite angle is 330. So make sure you are reading the question properly, whether it is reflex angle or the angle. So angle means the angle between hour hand and minute hand, that should be less than 180, and if it is reflex angle, it should be more than 180. Okay, so what is the reflex angle between the hands of clock at 10:25? So there is no separate formula to calculate the reflex angle. Calculate the angle, then subtract it from 360 degrees. That's it. So we have 11 into m is 25 here, divided by 2 minus 30 into what is the value of h? It's 10 here into 10. So if you simplify, you will get 275 by 2 minus 300. Once you subtract, you will get 162.5. This 162.5 is the angle between hour hand and minute hand. This is not the reflex angle. If you want to find the reflex angle, you have to subtract it from 360 degrees. 162.5. So simple, 197.5. So 197.5 is the reflex angle between the hands of clock at 10:25 p.m. So reflex angle should be always greater than 180 and the angle between the hands of clock should be less than 180 degrees. So let's move on to the next concept in the clock. So in this concept you will get the problem. First I will display the problems, then we'll come to this slide. So you will get a question like this: at what time between 4 and 5 will the hands of clock coincide? So you have to find the exact time between 4 and 5. Second question will be: what time between 4 and 5 o'clock will the hands of clock be at right angle? So we have to find the exact time of right angle. Similarly, at what time between 4 and 5 o'clock will the hands of clock point in opposite direction? So we have to find exact time in these three scenarios. Let's discuss this with the previous slide and the formula. Okay, so here is the three simple formulas you can remember to get this answer in a fraction of time. Okay, so first thing is, if you want to find the exact time when the coins and two hands coincide, means you have to use this formula 60h by 11, and if you want to find the right angle, use this formula 5h plus or minus 15 into 12 by 11 minutes past h. So 5h plus or minus means you have to find the value based on plus as well as minus. You will get two values. So one, the hover hand will be behind, and another, sorry, minute hand will be behind the hover hand, and next one is ahead of hover hand. So if you want to find the straight line, there are two scenarios. If the time is more than 6, that is 7 or 8 or 9 or 10 or 11, we have to use this formula. And if it is less than 6, it is 1, 2 up to 5, we have to use this formula. So which formula we have to use if time is 6 o'clock? So we know that exactly at 6 o'clock the hover hand and minute hand in opposite direction. So there is no need to use any formula. You can directly say the hover hand and minute hand will be in opposite at 6 o'clock. Exactly. Okay. So remember this formula, or you can take a screenshot of this formula and you can share it with your friends, or note down this formula in a paper. You will be solving the problems based on this in the next slide. Okay, so at what time between 4 and 5 will the hands of the clock coincide? So it is 60h by 11. So 60 into, you have to take the lowest value for h. So if it is 4 and 5, you have to take 4. If it is 10 and 11, you have to take 10 for this h value. So 60 into 4 by 11, simplify and you will get 240 by 11. If you simplify again, you will get 21:9 by 11. It means the hands of the clock will coincide after 21:9 by 11 seconds from 4 o'clock. That is 21:9 by 11 minutes past 4. You can imagine and check this angle. Okay. Or you can take the clock and rotate and find and check this answer is correct or not. So if you want to solve the problems in aptitude exam, just use the formula and get the answer directly. Next, what time between 4 and 5 o'clock will the hands of clock be at right angle? So right angle, we have two formulas. First one is 5h less or minus 15 into 12 by 11. So substitute the value, h is 5. You have to take the lowest value, 5 into 4 less or minus 15 into 12 by 11. So there are two scenarios. First one will be 5 into 4, 20, 20 plus 15, 35 into 12 by 11. And the second scenario is 20 minus 15, 5 into 12 by 11, which is equal to 60 by 11, or you can write 5 by 11. And in this scenario, if you simplify, you'll get 420 by 11, or you can write 38:2 by 11. So the hands of the clock will be in right angle twice from 4 to 5. So first one will be at 5 minutes 5 by 11 seconds, and the second one will be at 38:2 by 11 seconds. So you can check this answer by verifying in the clock also. So, or you can imagine and verify the answer. So in so if you have only one option in your aptitude, you can mark any one in this. Okay, so usually they don't give both answers, they will give at least any one. So you have to answer based on the option in the question. So next one, at what time between 4 and 5 o'clock will the hands of clock point in opposite direction? So here the time is 4 o'clock, we have to use the formula. That is, you have to use the second formula, 5h plus 30 into 12 by 11. So 5 into 4 plus 30 into 12 by 11. So basic simplification, simplify this and get the answer. So if you simplify, you get 600 by 11 or 54 6 by 11. So the hands of the clock will be in straight line after 54 minutes 6 by 11 seconds from 4 p.m. Okay. So it means 54 6 by 11 past 4 o'clock. So just substitute three formulas and get the answer directly. Let's move on to the next concept in this. So you will get a problem based on incorrect clocks. Incorrect clocks means the clock may run faster than the original clock or it may run slower than the original clock. So let's discuss an example with this. A watch gains 5 seconds in 3 minutes and was set right at 8 a.m. What time will it show at 10 p.m. on the same day? So a watch gains 5 seconds in 3 minutes means, so in 3 minutes it gains 5 seconds. So in 6 minutes definitely it will gain 6 seconds. Gaining in the sense, so that if correct was, so correct was completes 3 minutes, but the wrong watch completes 3 minutes and 5 seconds. It is faster than the actual clock. So in 3 minutes it completes, it gains 5 seconds. In 6 minutes it will gain 10 seconds. In 60 minutes it will gain 100 seconds. So 60 minutes means in 1 hour it will gain 100 seconds. Okay, so now calculate the time gap between 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. So 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. is 14 hours. So we have to calculate how many seconds it gained in 14 hours. So in 1 hour it gains 100 seconds. So in 14 hours it gained 1400 seconds. So convert this 1400 into minutes. That is 1400 by 60. You will get 23. And if you simplify, you will get 20 by 60. And if you simplify, you will get 1 by 3. Or you can write 23 and 20 seconds. So 23 is minutes and 20 is the seconds. So it means if correct watch shows 10 o'clock, our wrong clock will show 10, 23 and 20 seconds. So this is the concept of this problem. So watch gain 5 seconds in 3 minutes. So it means every 3 minutes, it's moving 5 seconds faster. So our question is, the watch was set right at 8 a.m. and what time it will show at 10 p.m. So 10 p.m. means 10 p.m. is the correct watch. What will be the time in our wrong watch? So if correct watch shows 10 p.m. and our wrong watch will show 10, 23 and 20 seconds. Now, a watch loses 5 minutes every hour. It means the watch is running slower than the original clock and was set right at 8 a.m. on Monday. When will it show the correct time again? So in this concept, the watch is losing 5 minutes in every hour. For example, they are setting the watch right at 8 a.m. So at 9 a.m., instead of 9 a.m., this watch will show only 8:55 a.m. So at 10 a.m., instead of 10 a.m., it will show 9:50 a.m. only. So every 1 hour it loses 5 minutes. So like this, we have to find when this watch will show the correct time again. So if this watch wants to show the correct time again, it should lose 12 hours. So if it loses 12 hours, this watch will show the correct time again. So every 5 minutes it loses, so every 1 hour it loses 5 minutes. So we have to calculate 12 hours. So cost required to lose this 12 hours. 12 hours means I'm converting it to minutes, so it will be 720 minutes. So the clock loses 5 minutes in every 60 minutes. How much time required to lose 720 minutes? This is the cost. So simply remember, if it should 12 hours, if it's so correct time means it should lose 12 hours. If you remember that, you can solve this problem. Simplify this 60 into 720 by 5, you will get 8640. Convert this to, this is minutes, convert this to hours, you will get 144 hours, or even you can convert to days, you will get 6 days. It means the after 6 days it will show 6 hours. Sorry, after 6 days it will show the correct time. So it should lose 12 hours to show the correct time. So 6 days means the watch was set right at 8 a.m. on Monday. So Monday plus 6 days, it will show 8 a.m. on next Sunday. So it requires 6 days to show the correct time again. So it's not after 12 days, it shows the correct time after 6 days. And Hemant, you have to please give the formula once again. So this video is recorded, you can watch the video once again and you can take the formula. So far we have discussed three types of problems in the clocks, and now move on to the concept of calendar. So if you want to solve the problem based on calendar, you should remember few basic concepts. And the first one is the concept of ordinary year and leap year and odd days. So we know we have 365 days in ordinary days and 366 days in leap year. So if you convert these days into weeks, you will get 52 weeks plus 1 day. In case of leap year, you will get 52 weeks plus 2 days. This 1 and 2 are the extra days after this complete week. So extra 1 day we are having after the 52 complete weeks. Similarly, in this case, we are having 2 extra days after 52 complete weeks. This extra day is called odd day in the concept of calendar. So extra day is odd day, that is number of days more than a complete week. For example, if you are having some 10 days, we have 1 complete week in this, that is 7 days. So remaining 3 is the odd day. For example, if you have 22 days, we have 3 complete weeks in this, that is 21 days will go in there. So we have 1 extra day. This 1 extra day or 3 extra day is called odd day in the concept of calendar. So if this odd day value is 0, it indicates Sunday, and 1 means Monday, 2 means Tuesday, 3 means Wednesday, and goes up to Saturday. And if it is 7 means, again it is equal to 0 and Sunday. If it is 8 means, equal to 1 and that is Monday. So remember the concept of odd day, you can easily solve all the problems related to this. The second thing you want to remember in the calendar concept is the concept of leap year. So we know 2012 is a leap year, 2016 is a leap year. How did we find? So divide this year by 4. So if it is a normal year, we have to divide the year by 4 and check whether the year is leap year or not. But if it is a century, like 100, 200, 300, we have to check one more condition. We have to divide this by 400 also. So for example, year 600 is divisible by 4. So we can't say 600 is a leap year. So we have to check one more condition, 600 by 400, and it fails in this case. So year 600 is not a leap year, even though it is divisible by 4. It should divide by 400 also. So for ordinary year, it should only divide by 4. For century, it should divide by 400 also. So we have discussed the concept of odd days. For ordinary year, we know one odd day. For leap year, we know we have two odd days. Now let's calculate how many odd days we are having for 100 years. So in 100 years, so let's assume the year starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and goes on up to 100. So in this case, year 4 is a leap year. Again, year 8 will be leap year. Year 12 will be leap year. So we will be having 25 leap year plus 75 in the normal scenario. So we have leap year once in every 4 years. So as per the basic logic, it will be 25 plus 75. But look at this, the year 100 is not a leap year. So after 96, the next leap year will be 104 and the not 100. So instead of 25, we will get 24 leap year plus 76 ordinary year in first 100 years. So we know we have 2 odd days for leap year and 1 odd day for ordinary year. So 24 into 2 plus 76 into 1 for this 100 years. So if you simplify, you will get 124 days, and if you convert this 124 into complete week, you will get 17 weeks plus 5 extra days. So this 5 day is called the odd day. It means Friday. So we have discussed in the first line, 5 indicates Friday. So the last day of this 100th year is Friday. So this is the only concept you have to remember. It is not 25 and 75, it is 24 and 76. So now let's calculate the odd day for the second 100 years, that is 200 years. We know first 100 years it is 5, for second 100 years you have to add another 5, that's it. So it will be equal to 10, we have 1 complete week, that is 7 days, and 3 is the extra odd days. So 3 means Wednesday. So Wednesday is the last day of 2nd century. So for 3, we have to add 3 times, it will be equal to 15, and we have 2 complete weeks, that is 4, and 1 is the odd day, that is Monday. In case of 400 years, we have to add 4 times, and look at this, in first 100, 200 and 300, this particular year, that is 100, 200 and 300 is a not leap year. So we have considered this year as an ordinary year. So 76 plus 25 concept is applicable for this, but the year 400 is a leap year, so we have to add extra 1 day for this leap year. So it will be equal to 21 and 0 odd days. So Sunday is the last day. The same cycle repeats for next 4 years, 5310 and 5310. So this cycle repeats for every 4 years. So in this previous example, we found Friday is coming, Wednesday is coming, Monday and Sunday. So what are the days missing? So in this list, Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday is missing. So it means the last day of any century cannot be Tuesday, Thursday or Saturday. So you may get this question in one more question. And also the last day of any century leap year is Sunday. Century leap year means 400, 800, 1200, 1600, 2000 and goes on. So it should be century plus leap year. So the last day will be always Sunday. So remember these two concepts and remember this value 5310. So if you remember, you can solve all types of calendar problems. So in this calendar, we will get two types of problem. First one is problem based on same calendar, and second one is problem based on finding a date from the given day. You have to find that day from the given day. So let's start with the same calendar problem. So can we use the 2018 calendar for some other years? Yes, we can use this calendar for some other years if the starting day of 2018 and the starting day of another year matches. So if, for example, the starting day of 2008 is Monday and the starting day of another year is Monday, we can use the calendar. But in both scenario, the year should be either ordinary year or leap year. So let's discuss how to find out the calendar which we can use for next year or following. So which of the following year will have same calendar as it was for the year 1997? So we have to find the suitable year for the calendar 1997. So if you get a question, write like this: 1997, 98, 99, 2000, 2001, 2. I am writing up to some 10 or 11 values. So we know 2019 is an ordinary year. So ordinary year have one odd day. 98 is ordinary year, so it have one odd day. So write the odd day counts here. So 1. 2000 is a leap year, so we have two odd days. Similarly, write for all the years. So you have to find the 7 multiples in this to get the answer. Here, add all these odd days, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 2 up to like this. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So you will get 7 odd days in this first one. You go to like this. So 7 means 1 week is completed and the next year calendar will be same as 1997 calendar. So 1997 calendar can be used in 2003. So simply write the year and write the odd days. You have to find the second 7 multiples. The next year will be the same calendar as for 1997. So you have to look for either 7 or 7 multiples like this. Let's look at one more problem based on the same concept. Which of the following year will have the same calendar as it was for the year 2007? So I'm writing here 2007, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. So 2007 is an ordinary year, so I'm writing 1. 8 is a leap year, so writing 2. Ordinary year, ordinary year, ordinary year, leap year, ordinary year, ordinary year, leap year, ordinary year, ordinary year, and ordinary. So now count for 7 multiples. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. There is no 7 here. So from 6 it is going to 8. So we cannot take this 13 as the same calendar for 2007. So we have to find exact multiple of 7. So up to this it is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and this is 14. So the next year calendar can be used for 2007 or 2007 calendar can be used for 2018. You can check the mobile calendar or laptop calendar and check your answer. So if you want to find the same calendar, you have to write the odd days and look for 7 multiples. It should be 7 or 14 or 21 and goes on like this. Okay, what was the day of week on 17th August 1983? So in this concept, you have to find the day. They will give only date and you have to find the day. There are two methods to solve this problem. I will explain both of them. I will explain first the ordinary method and I will explain you about the shortcut technique. Okay, so they have given 17th August 1983. So we have to divide this year as a century, complete year and the remaining days. So first thing you have to do is 1983, you have to take the nearest century leap year. Century leap year means 400, 800, 1200, 1600, 2000 and goes on. So you have to take the nearest and lowest century leap year. So nearest and lowest century leap year to 1983 is 1600. So 1600. We know the odd days for century leap year is 0. That's why we are taking this nearest century leap year. So next, how many years are remaining? In 1983, we have taken 1600. Next, we have 300 years. I'm taking the 100 part. So for 300 years, we'll get one odd day. So we have discussed earlier, for 100 years, we'll get 5. 200, we'll get 3. 300, will get 1 and 400 will get 0. So I'm taking 300, the odd days for 300 is 1. Next, how many complete years in this 83? So we have 82 complete years plus this 17 or up to 17th August in the 83. We are not having the complete 83rd year. We are having only 82 complete years plus some half of the year in 83. So 82 year means, so we have leap year in every 4 years. So it means we have 20 leap years in 80 years plus 62 ordinary years. So leap year means we have 2 odd days. So 20 into 2 plus 62. We have 102 odd days. If you convert this 102 into complete week, you will get 4 as a odd day. So find the complete week. Complete week will be 98 days and the remaining 4 days is odd day. So earlier we have 0, 1 and now it is 4. Now you have to calculate the time gap. number of days from 1st January to 17th August 1983. So in January we have 31 days, February 28 days, March 31 days, April 30, May, June, July, and 17 days in August. So we have to add all these days and find the odd days. Instead of doing adding all this, we can find the odd days from this itself. So if it is 31 days, number of odd days will be 3, because 28 will be the complete week. So we can directly reduce the value to 3 from this itself. So 28 is a complete week, so we can write 0, or 31 we can write 3, 30 we can write 2, 31 3, and 30 we can write 2, 31 we can write 3, plus 17, or even if you can reduce the 17, that's fine, you can reduce and proceed. So if you simplify, you will get 5 odd days. So we have divided this problem into 4 concepts. First one is century leap year, second one is century, and third one is complete year, and the fourth one is number of days from 1st January to the given day. So add all the odd days. We have 0, we have 1, and we have 4, and we have 5. So 0 plus 1 plus 4 plus 5. It means 10, and it is equal to 3. So 3 indicates Wednesday. So the day of the week on 17th August 1983 is Wednesday. So this is the technique to find the answer. So this is the ordinary traditional method you can use to find the date. In the next slide, I will tell you the shortcut to find this answer. So before discussing the shortcut, you have to understand the concept of doomsday. Doomsday means, if you look at calendar, there is last day of February. It could be 28 or 29. Last day of February, April 4, June 6, August 8, October and December. So all these dates will be same day. So even you can check in your calendar. So date, that is 4, 4, 6, 6, 8, 8, 10, 10, 12, 12 will be same day for every year. So if you check it 2018, it is Wednesday. If we check for 2017, it is Tuesday. It was Tuesday. So for all the year, these dates will be same. So day will be same. So 4, 4, 6, 6, 8, 8, 10, 10, 12, 12 will be same for every year. But each year it may vary. For 2018, it is Wednesday. 2017, it was Tuesday. And 2016, it will be. It will be some other day. So we have to find this common day for the given year. And from this, we will find the answer. Okay, so you have to remember a simple formula to calculate. So doomsday equal to constant plus year by 12 plus remainder by 4. So let me explain this with an example. So remember this constant value also. If the given year is in between this range, you have to use Friday as a constant. If the given year is between 19 in this range, you have to use Wednesday as a constant. Let's take the same example, that is 17th August 1983. So let's try to find the answer using this method. We know the constant is equal to Wednesday in this case, because we are going to find the value for 1983. 1983 comes in this range, so we have to use Wednesday as a constant. So doomsday equal to Wednesday plus year by 12 means, what is the year we are going to handle? So take only last two digits. 83 by 12. 83 by 12 means 6, and you will get remainder as 11. So you have to write the remainder here. Now divide this remainder by 4 again. So 11 by 4, you will get 2. Don't write the remainder again. So write and stop with the remainder by 4. So Wednesday plus 6 plus 11 plus 12 is a doomsday. So it means Wednesday plus 5, and you will get Monday as a doomsday for the year 1983. This is not our answer. We just found the doomsday for the year 1983. If you check the calendar, 4-4 of 1983, 6-6 of 1983, 8-8 of 1983 will be Monday. So also 10-10 and 12-12 will be Monday. So we just found the doomsday for the year 1993. We haven't found the answer yet. So what is our question? We have to calculate the day of 17th August means 8, 1983. So from this doomsday concept, we found that 8/8/1983 is Monday. So from this, we can easily form 17/8. That is, you have to add 9 days after Monday. So 9 days plus Monday equal to Wednesday. So you will get the answer directly. So one thing is, you have to find the doomsday for the given year, then you have to find the answer. Don't write the doomsday directly in the answer. So you have to remember few concepts to apply this doomsday. So basic first one formula, second one is the constant value, which is for this year. The same cycle repeats for next 4 set of centuries. So remember this concept, you can solve all the problems related to calendar in a few seconds. So don't use the ordinary method, it will take some time. So use the doomsday concept and practice problem based on this. If you want to check this answer, you can find the day of your birthday. So I hope everyone know your birthday. So calculate your birthday from your date. Okay, so far we have discussed two concepts, clocks and calendar. So clocks, we have discussed three types of problem. First one is angle calculation, time calculation, and third one is the concept based on incorrect clocks. In clocks, we have discussed two concepts, problem based on same calendar and the problem based on this, finding a day when a date is given. So practice more problem based on this and try to solve this problem in less than 30 seconds. So as I said earlier, I'm going to tell you about the Codespiration, which is All India Coding Contest, which we are going to conduct on April 15th. The students from any engineering discipline, MCA, BCA, BSc or Arts graduates can participate in this event. So the event will happen on April 15, 2018 Sunday. So the registration link is here, po.stcodespiration, or you can directly register from our placement season website. So once you open, you will get a link to register. So if you win in this contest, you will get the prizes which is listed here. So first prize, second prize and third prize. So we'll be providing, we'll be giving 3 prizes to the winners. So apart from this, the top coders will get the opportunity to do internship in top product companies. So these 3 are the prize for the winners, and the top coders will also get the benefits. You will get the chance to do internship in the product companies. So here is the registration link, po.st/codespiration. You can share this link with your friends and ask them to register. So the detailed procedure is available in this page. So register and win the exciting prizes. So those who are watching this video regularly know about our Prepare for Placement Season 2019 batch. So we have topic wise coding and aptitude test. You can practice this, and we have coding assessment and one national level coding contest which we conduct regularly. Also, you can practice unlimited company mock tests in this same Prepare for Placement Season package. If you are a 2019 batch and you are looking for some good campus placement, so we suggest you to practice in this way and crack any type of placements. We are also having one more package, it's called unlimited company specific test. So in this you will get 300 super dream company specific tests. So if you want to target some companies and if you want to crack campus recruitment, you can use this package. So this is the discount code you can use to purchase. If you use PrepPS 2019, you will get 50% discount on Prepare for Placement Season test package. And if you use crack any placement, you will get 25% discount on unlimited company placement mock test package. So this is the free resources you can use and practice. So next comes the training schedule for April 2019. So on April 4, that is next Wednesday, we are going to discuss number system. On 11th April, we will be discussing HCF, LCM and remainder theorem. On 18th, we will be discussing algebra and equations. On 25th, we will be discussing problems on ages. So note down the schedule and watch the videos on every Wednesday at 8 p.m. So thank you for watching this video. You can register for Codespiration in the given link. Okay. So practice more problems. All the best. Thank you, friends.